folks, this week I wanted to share with you some of the amazing artworks by Rafael Lozano Hemmer. So Rafael is a Mexican artist, born 1967. He emigrated to Canada, where he studied at Concordia University. He actually started out as a chemist, but began making interactive and performance-based artworks later. He's won numerous awards and is extremely prolific. He is one of the most prolific artists working in interactive media that I know of. The quantity of projects he's done is truly impressive. I'm going to share a few of them with you today, but I encourage you to check out his website to see more of his works. The first one I'm going to show you is Pulse Room, and this piece got him a lot of recognition back in 2006, and it's a installation that can be scaled to a variety of different spaces where there's bare light bulbs hanging from the ceiling, and each light bulb is blinking on and off at a slightly different rate from each other. As you can see in this image, there's a kind of pedestal at the front of the exhibition with two handles on it. You can walk up and hold onto those handles, and then there's a light bulb hanging right in front of your face if you're in front of this pedestal. You can see it's off in this image. And when you hold the handles, it measures your heartbeat. And then the light in front of you will pulse at your heartbeat. And then it gets added, that light gets added to the rest of the array, right? So after you do this, you realize that all of the lights are blinking on and off at the speed of someone else's heart rate. And so you've contributed your heartbeat to the installation, and it becomes one with all the other heartbeats that are there. In Microphones from 2008, there's a similar array of many different devices here, although they all appear similar. You can walk up and talk to any one of these microphones, and it will respond to you with a speaker that's built into the microphone with the last thing that was said to it. So it's usually going to tell you something that was said by someone else. And in this way, it creates this kind of strange conversation going backwards in time across the installation. Pulse Index from 2010. It's similar to the other two. You might notice a trend here, how he kind of captures some bit of data from the visitors to his exhibitions and then turns that into the art piece. On this one, you can see there's a thumbprint scanner on the wall. And when you hold your thumb there, it will capture your thumb and then add it to this array that you see behind this person of the thumbprints that it has captured already. It only keeps the most recent 765 thumbprints, and you can see they like get reduced in size by a quarter each like step of the way. I think that has something to do with how many of the thumbprints it keeps before they become infinitesimally small. And these images likewise pulse in brightness in time with the heartbeat of the person who contributed them. Tape recorders from 2011. This one is fairly straightforward. You can see these tape measures mounted at the base of the wall there, and they extend as long as someone's standing in front of them. So if someone's standing in front of them, then they will slowly extend the tape measure and get taller. And there's a little printer in the exhibition space that prints the total viewer time for each tape measure every hour on the hour. And you can imagine that this creates some interesting effects. There's a 3 meter limit on the tape meters. So if they get too tall, they might fall over and collapse. And then if they get to that 3 meter limit, they retract and it starts over. All right, in voice array, we've got a video. Let's check this out. So you can see how the participant's voice gets added to the array and it reflects down the light beam of this installation. He has a number of pieces similar to this using light and voice in trying to represent the wave of the voice through light, either in a tunnel or a searchlight or similar. Please Empty Your Pockets also has a video. And this is one of my favorite pieces of his. It obviously references airport security inspections. You can place anything you want on this conveyor, this white conveyor belt. It will go through the scanner there, and you can pick it up again, and it is photographed your object and is projecting it then directly onto where it was on the belt, and the projection moves in time with the belt, and it gets added to a collection of all the other things that have been scanned by other people on the installation. It's a really beautiful piece. It's extremely well done, and if you've done a lot of airport travel, it's like very visceral in the kind of emotions it brings up in dealing with security lines, and then also somewhat creepy in how it has like captured this aspect of you and added it to the installation again, which gets you to think about like the security and the data that is captured from you whenever you do any kind of travel. Sphere Packing from 2013. This is an interesting installation of his as well. He's made a number of 3D printed spheres. Each sphere represents a different composer. Each song that composer has made has its own speaker on the sphere. So you'll see these little silver discs on the spheres. Each one of those represents one song that composer wrote. All of the songs play at once on infinite loops. And the interesting thing about this, besides the sonic quality of it, is just the data visualization aspect of it, to me anyhow. You can immediately see the different scopes that the different composers are working with, and you can see some of them write a great number of songs, and some of them only write a few songs. ...1984 that he did 30 years later, actually, in 2014. This piece displays a random selection of numerals that say 19, 84. The numerals you can see are taken from Google Street View. So they are the numbers captured from actual people's houses and businesses. There's millions of different photos and combinations and different ways to display 1984. And you'll notice there's a keypad there that also has the, like, tiny versions of these images on it for the numbers. You can click those and enter whatever number you want, and that will display on the larger display on the left. However, it will always then count up or count down back to 1984, right? And so he's making a clear comment here about the sort of surveillance capitalism society that we live in now, and referencing that to Orwell's literature. All right, for Airborne, we've got a video. So you can see as someone approaches this piece, their profile is captured and incorporated into it. And doing so causes the text that's scrolling below to be free of its lines and start to entwine and ensnare the person. Which creates these unique patterns. All right, level of confidence, also 2015. This is a very political piece that he did to commemorate the mass kidnapping of 43 students in Iguala, Mexico. It uses face detection, typically used by the police to match the viewers to the faces of the missing students. So it on the left you can see the visitor's face, and on the right you can see one of the students' faces, and it measures the proportions of your face. It scans through the 43 images it has of the missing students, and sees how it chooses whichever student you most closely resemble to show you. And so he's trying to raise awareness of this problem that they had in Mexico with this kidnapping. And then also in a sort of very kind of hopeful way, trying to match you to one of these people, right? On the off chance that the children were able to escape and get in front of this piece, right? It would let you know that you've made a successful match. So level of confidence has to do with the piece's ability to tell you how confident it is that you are one of these lost children. It's intentionally idealistic, I think, in that regard, and more done to raise awareness about the kidnapping topic. Pan Anthem is another kind of data visualization piece. In this installation, there's statistics. You can see the statistic, for instance, in this piece on the very top, so showing the homicide rate per year per 100,000 inhabitants. And it's dividing nations up, into numerical categories here based on their homicide rate. The speakers, there's a little squares you see. Each one represents a different country and plays the national anthem of that country. And again, this is all at once, so it's a bit cacophonous, but when you're standing directly in front, I'm sorry, the speakers only play when you stand directly in front of them, so you can hear the national anthems of that data category while you're standing in front. Just those speakers play. However, as you'll see, some of the categories have numerous speakers, so it'll still create a bit of a cacophonous noise at some levels. Call on Water 2016. I also have a video of this one, I believe. Yes. This piece is striking, with you working with mist and water. The display only activates when people are around. And it displays a series of poems by Octavio Paz. Redundant Assembly from 2016 dynamically compiles six perspectives of the viewer into a single image. So it's a bit like a cubist, a digital cubist work. There's six cameras in the gallery capturing different angles of the viewer, and then the algorithm automatically combines them into a single image. So you can see this person represented on the display from multiple angles at once, kind of overlaid, creating a recognizable face, but abstracted at the same time. Sway, also from 2016, is a sort of upside down noose. Also a very political piece. It does, in fact, sway side to side, slightly like a metronome would. And it does this at a rate of once per minute, going from side to side, which is roughly equal to the global homicide rate. So once every minute somewhere on Earth, a person kills another person. And he's representing that statistic with this sculpture. Bilateral Time Slicer from 2016 is the last piece I will show you of his. Uses face detection to tell where the person standing in front of it is. And it will add them to this array of images. You can see behind them how it kind of like takes the central person, and then over time you get split in half and split in half and split in half and pushed out to the edges as more people come in. They're always inserted into the middle, right? And whoever was there last is split in half and sliced. It's very interesting. It's very good at tracking the face to keep the person centered, even if you are in fact not centered in front of the work. And then you can kind of see a line there too. It's measuring your eye level and keeping the whole piece like centered around wherever you are standing, using some computer vision stuff. This is not new technology. This has been around for quite a while, the face tracking and computer vision stuff. But this I thought was particularly significant because he had this piece at Untitled Art, which is part of Art Basel in Miami, in 2016. So showing that these interactive media works can be shown at extremely high scale fine arts venues. And then when people step away, it slowly merges the people back together. As you see here. All right, so that's some of the work by Rafael Lozano Hemmer.